गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द न्यू चैप्टर ऑफ बायोलॉजी, दैट इज फर्स्ट चैप्टर, चैप्टर 5, फंडामेंटल यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ अकॉर्डिंग टू योर एनसीईआरटी बुक. सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द सेल. यू नो द सेल, सेल इज द स्ट्रक्चरल एंड फंक्शनल यूनिट ऑफ अवर लाइफ. ओके, वेरियस साइज एंड शेप ऑफ द सेल्स. ओके, यूकैरियोटिक, प्रोकैरियोटिक ऑर्गेनिज्म, एनिमल सेल, प्लांट सेल्स, द पार्ट्स ऑफ सेल्स. ओके, मेजर पार्ट ऑफ सेल्स, प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन, साइटोप्लाज्म, न्यूक्लियस. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द चैप्टर. सेल, सेल, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय सेल? जस्ट लाइक अ मैटर, मैटर हैव अ यूनिट, एटम और मॉलिक्यूल्स. ओके, एटम इज अ यूनिट ऑफ मैटर. Just like that, cell is the unit of a life, of living thing. Okay, any living, because they have life. So the structure and function unit of life is cell. First of all, cell was observed by Robert Hooke in 1665, where in the bark of tree. Okay, and he observed that they looks like a honeycomb. Compartment, different types of compartment, like a honeycomb, okay, in a bark of a tree. And about cell, we studied the cell, cell structures, different type of cells, okay, cell organelles in cell biology. Cell biology is the branch of biology in which we studied in detail about the cell and their structures and their organelles. Okay, so compound microscope having many parts. Basic part are eyepieces, objective lens and condenser to observe a cell after putting a drop of staining solution. What is staining solution? Seen in your laboratory, in your composite lab or in your bio lab, there are some staining solution, colored solution. They are colored like blue color, like pink color. Okay, they are staining solution. Actually, they are staining solution, and they are used to staining these cells, so that cells or tissues, means which tissue, which cells you take in a slide, and then you staining them, so that under the microscope you can see clear the parts. Okay. So safranin is the staining solution used for plant cells, staining for plant cell, and the methylene blue is used for animal cell, staining for animal cell. Okay, scientists named Leeuwenhoek saw first living cells in the pond water for the first time. In the first time he saw some living cells in pond water. Okay, so he was called, from that time he was called father of microbiology, father of microbiology. Okay, Robert Brown was another scientist who discovered the nucleus in the cell. Okay, cell theory, what is cell theory? The cell theory is not another thing. This is the given by Sladen and Swan. All plants, according to Sladen and Swan, all plants and animals are composed of cells. Okay, all living things are composed of a unit called cell, and this theory was further expanded by Virchow, and according to him, all cells arise from the pre-existing cells. Okay, omnicellulae celluli. Okay, all cells are arise from the pre-existing cells. Cells are differ in various size, shape, structures, like onion cells, smooth muscle cells, blood cells, bone cells, fat cells, nerve cells, various cells. Okay, very different types of cells. A single cell may constitute whole organism, like in amoeba, chlamydomonas, paramecium, bacteria. They all have unicellular, they all are unicellular, and human beings are multicellular. Okay, human beings are multicellular. All cells have basically three portions, three parts. you already learn in your class 8, okay? That is PM, that is plasma membrane, cytoplasm, nucleus, okay? Three basic parts are plasma membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus. If we talk about plasma membrane, this is the outer covering of the cell and they are called selective permeable membrane. Why they are called selective permeable? Because they only allows the selective materials, selective ions to inside or outside the cell, okay? Helps in diffusion and osmosis. They help in diffusion and osmosis. And they diffusion, what do you mean by diffusion? Diffusion is not another. This is the movement of substance from the higher concentration to the lower concentration. Okay. So exchange of CO2 and O2 with the external environment. This is diffusion, okay? Just like higher concentration, this one is higher, here higher concentration, and this movement of substance take place in lower concentration, okay? So this is a simple type of a diffusion, okay? Now osmosis is also type of diffusion, but here the passage of water take place, okay? The passage of water from the higher region to the lower region of water concentration through a selective permeable membrane, okay? So this is the osmosis, like this one having this is the wall, okay? This is the membrane here, highly soluble. This is the high solvent then solid. Here solvent are higher than solute particles, here solvent are less than solute particles, okay? These circles are solute particles. So always remember that solvent are flow from the higher to lower, because here solvent are higher but here solute are higher, okay? So from the higher portion, the higher concentration, it flows to the lower concentration. Only what particles? Only water molecules, water molecules, okay? So based on this process, osmosis process, there are three types of solution. One is isotonic, second one is hypotonic, next one is hypertonic solution, okay? These three type of solution we will discuss in next lecture in detail, what are these types of solutions, okay? Now if water is taken by the cell, then it is endocytosis. Endo means taken, inside the cell, okay? So then this one is the endocytosis. And if the water is expelled out of the cell, means cell is shrinkage, here cell is shrinkage, so it is exosmosis. In exosmosis, cell is shrinkage, and is in endocytosis, cell is swell up, okay? Because water is take up by the cell, so it is swell up, and in exosmosis it is shrinking, it is shrink because the water molecules are expelled out of the cell, okay? So different types of solution we will discuss further in next lecture. And nucleus, cell wall, nucleus, okay? And cytoplasm, eukaryotic, prokaryotic cell, what are the eukaryotes, what are the prokaryotes, and also animal and plant cells, okay? So thank you.